St. Johns County students head back to school in just a couple of days on Friday, and law enforcement really working on the best way to keep those students safe. Undersheriff Matt Cline is here to talk about school security changes. I know that the school security is just absolutely top of mind for parents. What's being done in St. Johns County to make sure that kids are safe?
I think the first thing that we need to say and let all the parents know is that, you know, school starts this Friday. I don't think the kids are very happy about starting school on Friday, but it does start this Friday. And there will be an armed personnel person in every single school, whether it's an armed deputy sheriff or an armed private security member, that every school will be covered.
Now, you are working very closely with the school board. How are the two entities working together?
When this law first came out, the very first thing that we did is we started to form some committees and figure out what are the resources, where are the, if there's any gaps anywhere, where do we fill them? And we started doing, you know, site safety checks on all the schools and figuring out, you know, what can we change? What's the low-hanging fruit that we can go ahead, make some safety changes right now, and get everything in place by the start of the school year? So this has been a busy summer for us.
I know it certainly has. Well, and talking about the breakdowns of some of the numbers of what you're going to have located in different schools. I know that you're going to have an officer in each school. Can you go over some of the actual statistics of what will be taking place?
We are. St. Johns County has 40 schools at the beginning of the school year next year. We're probably going to have somewhere between 15 and 19 deputy sheriffs in every school. And then for all of the gap that's left over, there's going to be an armed security personnel in each one. Now, we've hired, started the hiring process for deputies from the money that's coming from Tallahassee as a result of this new school safety bill. As they get through training and we start to implement them, we'll take experienced deputies that are already out on the road and we're going to start to infiltrate them into our schools. The ultimate goal being is that every school will have an armed deputy sheriff, you know, in attendance. Now, keep in mind, just because there's a private security person at a school doesn't mean that there may not also be an overlap of an armed deputy sheriff. We're not necessarily putting out the fact that, you know, these schools have private security, these schools have deputy sheriffs. Mm-hmm. There's going to be some overlap. There may be, just because there's a private security personnel, you may have two or three armed deputies that are there at the school at any given time.
And I'm sure a lot of parents feel even safer knowing that. And of course, you know, giving that information out, it is not something that you'd want to do, because the student safety is the first and most paramount thing here. What kind of training are these individuals going through?
Well, obviously, the deputies, you know, they go through regular deputy training. Now, the private security personnel, I can't really speak to what, you know, what their training is, but I do know that our school superintendent, Tim Forsum, you know, vetted this firm, you know, thoroughly to make sure that it was going to be a good fit, it was going to be a round peg for a round hole, and they feel very confident moving forward. But keep in mind, as the school year goes on, the private security personnel are probably going to start to backtrack a little bit as we start to implement more and more deputy sheriffs. Now, I think the one important thing that we really want to push and kind of give it a humanistic side to it is a lot of our deputies, men and women, have children that are in these schools. They have a lot of buy-in. If you want to make somebody, you know, feel, you know, accountable to something, make them responsible. There's no bigger or greater responsibility of the relationship between a parent and a child. So a lot of our deputies are parents to children that are in these schools that we're talking about. So we feel very confident that our deputies are very, very concerned about what's going on in our schools.
I was going to ask you that, because I think that really puts it in perspective. You know, when you have men and women working in your department and their kids are in the schools, you know, nearby in your county, I absolutely, just like you said, I mean, that absolutely makes it, you know, even more accountable and puts it in perspective.
That's right. You're going to see a lot of police presence come Friday.
Yeah, absolutely. And what about see something, say something? I know that that's really important, and that's another message you want to get out, not just to the students, but to mm-hmm. anybody that comes close to a school.
Communication is key. Just like in all problems that we have, especially in government, you can usually track that back to a lack of communication. Well, a lot of the problems that we see in our schools and tragedies that we see is a lack of communication, so communication is definitely key. We're going to put a lot of emphasis on that. And I'll tell you, probably an unintended consequence of having all of these deputies and security personnel in the schools is just going to kind of, you know, create a little bit more communication, and that's going to be beneficial to all of us.
One last question. Do you think parents are a lot more comfortable? What's the feedback that you've been getting?
I think that our parents already felt comfortable with the amount of safety and security that were in our schools. This isn't going to hurt. I think this is going to do nothing but help. So it's probably a step in the right direction.
All right. Undersheriff Matt Cline with St. Johns County. Good luck with back to school.
Thank you, Nikki.
I know it seems like it just came so fast, doesn't it?
It did, yeah.
All right. Thank you very much. And let's give it back to Crystal.